Person Morgan Ortegas to talk about both. Happy 4th to you, Morgan. Thanks for taking time with us today.
Happy 4th, Jillian. Thank you for having me.
So in a bit of a head scratcher, just a few moments ago at the White House, the president said, of all things, the teacher shortage in this country poses a national security threat to America. He also, in another head scratcher on Friday, said this about Afghanistan. Listen.
Yeah, but just coming back there. Remember what I said about Afghanistan? I said Al-Qaeda would not be there. I said it wouldn't be there. I said we'd get help from the Taliban. What's happening now? What's going on? Read your press. I was right.
Morgan, is it clear to you how the Taliban is helping America in the region?
No. You know, the emperor clearly seems to have no clothes on whenever it comes to the national security analysis that's being briefed to him. What do we know as a fact almost 2 years after that disastrous and chaotic withdrawal, Jillian? We know that ISIS-K, ISIS Khorasan, has a footprint in every region of Afghanistan. And of course, we see the devastating effect that the Taliban takeover has had on the women in Afghanistan. You know, closing the beauty salons, while, you know, tragic for the women who are the entrepreneurs and business owners and women who may just go there for a sense of community, it shows the larger problem of the Taliban in control, where they are not allowing women to be employed, not allowing women to have education. Now, what do we also know, Jillian? Well, Friday afternoon, just a few days ago, on a holiday weekend, Biden's State Department very, I think, disgracefully released a report. They didn't allow any officials to comment on the record. It was a background brief. And the report covered what we all know now to be true 2 years later, that the disastrous and chaotic withdrawal from Afghanistan did not have to happen in the way it did. It did not have to be inevitable that the Taliban would take over. We certainly did not need to lose those 13 American brave men and women that we lost in that chaotic and disgraceful withdrawal. And I just want to say, as someone who has served and have had many members of my family serve overseas, to the parents of those 13, to the family members of those 13 Americans, you deserve so much more than that report to be leaked on a late Friday afternoon and a holiday weekend. And we are mourning the loss of your children and your family members still 2 years later.
And to your point, it was certainly not inevitable that the Taliban would surge back to power in about 2 weeks, as turned out to be the case. Well, I have you, Morgan. Quickly, before we go, I want to ask for your take on what we're seeing unfold in the West Bank this holiday weekend.
Well, I thought Trey's reporting has been excellent today. Fox is lucky to have him out there and to keep us all informed. For the bigger picture, to help our viewers understand why this had to happen, why this Israeli military operation had to happen, first of all, you must know that Iran, the Islamic Republic of Iran, is financing and training, providing technical support, operational support to these terrorist groups that are in Jenin. And so that is important because we see Iran, they continue to threaten Israel. And really, the Palestinian Authority, that leadership basically has no control over Jenin anymore. They have no control over these terrorist groups. And so, unfortunately, Israel, their military has to go in with a very extensive operation. They're even finding things and having to deal with things that Iran has given these terrorist groups, like IEDs. So this is a sophisticated terrorist command center that was attacked last night. It's a sophisticated hub for terrorists. And Israel has to do what is best to protect themselves. But make no mistake that the Islamic Republic of Iran is behind these terrorist groups. And the Biden administration's policies to give Iran sanctions relief will only embolden these terrorist groups that threaten the state of Israel.